Exercise 1.12. An electron and a proton are allowed to fall through the separation between the plates of a parallel plate capacitor of 5 volt and separation distance h is equal to 1 millimeter as shown in figure. Now this is how the electron and the neutron are allowed to fall, okay, in between the parallel plates. Okay, so here this is an electron and a neutron. Here there is a proton. Okay. Now, calculate the time of flight for both electron and protons. So we have to find it out how much time is taken for an electron to reach and also for a proton to reach. Suppose, if the neutron is allowed to fall, what is the time of flight? Suppose the neutron is allowed to fall, we have to find out the time of flight. Among three, which will reach the bottom first? Which one will reach the bottom first? Now, what are the things given? Mass of proton is given, mass of electron is given, and what is G value is given. And what are the other data given in the problem? The electric field is given. The electric field is given as how much? 5 volt. That is potential between. Voltage is given. Okay. Potential is what? Given. That is how much? 5 volt. Okay, V is given as what? 5 volt. Okay. And the distance of separation is given. It is taken as what? H. That is how much? 1 millimeter. That is taken as 1 millimeter. Voltage is given as 5 volt. H is equal to 1 millimeter. Okay. This can be written as 1 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter. Now, first thing, we have to find out the time of flight. So, time of flight for proton and electron. Okay. So, for that, we are going to take the equation S is equal to ut plus half at square. Okay. Here, the initial velocity is 0. So, what you can write S is equal to half at square. Now, what we have to find it is what? T. T is equal to, here your S is what? H. Distance is what? H. Okay. So, it is T square is equal to 2H by A. So what is T? T is equal to root of 2H by A. But we don't know the acceleration. Now according to Newton's second law, F is equal to what? Ma. So which implies what? A is equal to F by M. What is F? F is equal to what? E. Okay. Charge into field. Okay. So that is E by M. Okay. Now I am going to substitute in T. T is equal to root of 2H by E by M. So this can be written as root of 2H M by E. Okay. Now you know the value for what? H. You know the mass. Mass is given in the problem. E we have to calculate. How to calculate the E? E value E is equal to V by D. Potential by distance. What is potential? 5 volt. 5 volt into 1 into 10 raised to minus 3. That is 1 meter. So what is the value? 5 into 10 raised to 3 volt per meter. Now we can find out the time of flight for electron. Time of flight of electron is equal to root of 2H ME by E. E ME is for mass of electron. Okay. So I can substitute the values. So in order to substitute the values, 2 into 1 into 10 raised to minus 3 into mass, here it is what? 9.1 into 10 raised to minus 31 divided by E value 5 into 10 raised to 3 into 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 90. So when you multiply these two, you will be getting 18.2 into 10 raised to minus 34 divided by 8 into 10 raised to minus 16. Okay. So this can be written as root of 2.275 into 10 raised to minus 18. Okay. Now if you take the root, what will you get here is 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 9 seconds. So that can be written as 1.5 nanosecond. This is your time of flight for electron. Now we'll go for finding the time of flight for proton. So for proton, it is 2H mass of proton by E into E. So what you can write here, 2 into h value is 1 into 10 raised to minus 3. What is the mass of proton? 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 27 kg divided by capital E value is what? 5 into 10 raised to 3. E value is what? 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 90. Here 1.6 and 1.6 will get what? Cancelled. Okay. So what will we get here? It is 2 by 5 root of 2 by 5 into 10 raised to, here it is minus 30, okay, into 10 raised to, this it is going minus 16, if it is goes up, it is plus 16, okay. So, what we get here is, it is 2 by 5, what is 2 by 5? 2 by 5 is 0.4, so it is 0.4 into 10 raised to minus 14. So, if you take the value here, if you take the root here, what will you get here is 0.63 into 10 raised to minus 7. So, this can be written as 63 into 10 raised to minus 9. So, this is in seconds. So, this can be written as 63 nanosecond. Coming to the second part of the question, suppose if a neutron is allowed to fall, what is the time of flight? Okay. Now, neutron is a neutral charge. Neutron is a what? Neutral charge. So, it will not experience an electric field. Okay. So, we have to take it as a free fall. We have to take it as a what? Free fall. So, the time period for free fall is root of 2h by g. T is equal to what? 2h by g. Okay. So, we can find it out. We know the value of h and g. G is taken as what? 10. Okay. So, T is equal to root of, here 2 into 1 into 10 raised to minus 3 divided by 10. Okay. So, here it is what you will be get 2 into 10 raised to minus 4 you will be getting. So, what is the answer here? What is root 2? Root 2 is 1.414 into 10 raised to minus 2 second. This is the time of flight for what? A neutron. We can write it as n to in order to differentiate. So this is time of flight for neutron. So we have found out the time of flight for electron as what? T is equal to 1.5 newton-second. Tp as what? 63 nanosecond. And Tn as what? 1.414 into 10 raised to minus 2 second. Now what is the third part of the question is, among the three, which one will reach the bottom first? Now, we have to find it out. Now, here you compare the three values. The one which is having the smallest value will reach the bottom first. Here, this is in 10 raised to 9. This is also in 10 raised to 9. This is in 10 raised to minus 2. So, this is the highest value. Now, among these two, this is highest. So, which one is having the lowest value? The electron is having the what? Lowest value. So, the electron will reach first. So, the one which is having time 1.9 nanosecond will reach the bottom first. That is nothing but what? Electron.